Making video ads for Facebook and Instagram can be such a powerful way for you to capture the attention of your target audience. But it can also be super overwhelming knowing how to actually create these things. What video software do you use? Where do you find video clips and music and images and transitions? And how do you put it all together in a way that actually keeps people engaged? It can be a lot. So in this video, I'm going to be taking you through step by step how to create one of these beautiful video ads all inside of Canva. I'm going to start by showing you how to find inspiration for your video ads. Then we're going to go through how to actually structure your video ad in a way that actually makes people engage with your content. And then finally, we'll put it all together inside of Canva with your music and your video clips and text and everything else in a way that is ready to be exported into your Facebook Ads Manager and be used for your Facebook and Instagram ads. And if you do find the content here valuable, I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel so I can keep on supporting you through your marketing journey through more tutorials like this one. Now, if you're ready, let's get straight into it. Okay. So let's first talk about where to draw inspiration from before you start designing your ads. My go-to is to go into Facebook Ads Library and just look at competitors that are doing something with their video marketing and seeing what they're doing and what I might be able to pull inspiration from, or just looking at agencies that are marketing agencies, copywriting agencies, basically any agency that's within a creative space is usually doing some form of cool video marketing that you can pull inspiration from. And my go-to is Ad Zombies. These guys do their video content super well because they have mastered the art of curiosity. You know, they're a copywriting agency specifically for Facebook and Instagram ads, but this is a video of a woman eating chicken from a bucket, right? Like, there's just so much curiosity going on here and lots of good stuff that we can learn from. Here's one that I saw earlier, which is actually only 7 seconds, and it just says, "This ad doesn't bite, it just converts," and gives you the heebie-jeebies, right? So it's super, super quick. It just loops, but it's super curiosity inducing. And it also gives you a really quick call to action to get in touch with their team if you want to learn how to create awesome ads like this one. And here's another one down here. I'm just going to mute it so you guys don't have to hear the music, but all it says is mind-blowing copywriting. And then it's got this kind of looping video that's a bit of a static image, bit of animation, and it's sort of a mind-blowing video. And it says, "We warned you, our copywriting will blow your mind too." All right, so that really, really makes you want to get in touch with their team because you're like, that's a really freaking cool ad and I want Facebook ads like that one. Even though they're technically experts in copywriting, not video creation, but their ads really get your attention. But I know it's not always possible to see your competitors' advertising or even find the right people to emulate from within Facebook Ads Library, which is why I'm going to be giving you one more resource, which is promo.com. So these guys actually have a platform that's all about creating awesome video ads and video content for your business, but they can be a little bit on the pricier side if you're not running an agency or don't have the budget for this yet. But there's nothing wrong with using them for inspiration, especially because they've got specific industries within their categories that you can pull from, like real estate. And I know they've got some education and e-commerce and music, health and fitness, travel and tourism. So this is where you can jump into and be like, all right, I want to get a bit of inspiration for what I can do for my ads within the travel and tourism space, and then preview the ad, take a look at what they've done. I'm just going to mute this one again and see how you might be able to emulate what they've done here. Obviously not copying directly, but just drawing some inspiration from it. And one thing that you'll notice with all of their ads is that they're very, very similar to what we saw with Ad Zombies, where there's a hook, maybe a little bit of content in the middle, and then just a call to action. So that is the bare minimum that you need to do with your video ads. They can be just really short, really punchy. It doesn't have to be this long, you know, couple of minutes worth of video content. It can just be something that you can communicate to your audience in 10 seconds or less and give them a call to action. So that's exactly what we're going to be creating with our ad today. And the next step really is just to gather the video clips that you want to be using in your ads. So if you already have your own video clips you want to use, that's awesome. But for those of you that don't have that, I would recommend going to Pexels.com and pulling some videos from their free to use library here. Now, full disclosure, Canva actually does pull from Pexels within their software as well. So you can just search for their videos from directly from within Canva. But in my opinion, it's a lot easier to search for stuff within Pexels, because as soon as you click into one clip, it will then say, hey, these are similar videos that you might want to check out. And in this case, they're all the same model that is doing different things in different clips. So that makes it really, really easy for you to create that kind of continuous flow within your ad. So I would recommend going straight to Pexels to research your clips and then download them from there and upload straight into Canva and start creating. Within Canva, just search for a video ad and then select the one that's best for what you're trying to create based on the dimensions of what it's suggesting to you. I would probably say that the basic frame video ad or the Facebook Shops video ad is a really good one to start with for Facebook and Instagram ads, because the dimensions are 1080 by 1350, which is a really good vertical dimension. You can also go with square video ads, but these will give you a little bit more real estate on the platforms. So I'm just going to go ahead and select this one, and then we'll play around with it and customize it. Just going to go ahead and rename this. So it's going to be my test video ad. And I'm also going to drag in a few pages from a different template that I've got over here. So I want to create a couple of these and maybe one more of these. So I don't want to create too many pages, because keep in mind that we don't want this thing to be too long, but that looks pretty good to me. And what I'm going to do next is just drag in my uploaded videos from Pexels. So you'll notice that these are quite long. So we are going to go through and trim these, and I can give you recommendations on the ideal duration as well, but you'll have to test this out for yourself. But for now, we're just going to drag these in and then we're going to trim them all. So I'm going to drag in this one here and let's do one more. And actually for this one, what I'm probably going to do is just make it full screen, because some of your video clips should actually have no borders around them at all. And that can be a really powerful way of getting people's attention. So we've got our initial video clips. We want to make sure that it's on brand. So for this in particular, maybe the colors are not quite right. The fonts probably aren't quite right either. So heading on over to styles, I've got some of my brand colors already preset in here. So I would probably go with my blues, because I quite like using these for ads. That looks pretty good. So it's basically using my blue and my white, and I can say apply that to all pages. And now it's made everything all nice and branded for me. And I can do the same thing with the font here if I wanted to, or I can just drag in text elements one by one. So I'm just going to go ahead and let's trim these first, actually, before adding in our text. So my ideal duration for each video clip is about 3 to 3.5 seconds. So you can actually just say, I want 3 seconds. It's going to only select the very first 3 seconds, but you can move this around to find the right part of the video clip that you want to use, and then just click on done. Keep in mind, you can always change this. So just because you've selected those particular 3 seconds doesn't mean that that can't be changed in the future. But just for demo purposes at the moment, we're happy with those. And then let's do another 3 seconds here. Now for this one, it's going to be a little bit different, because I am going to be advertising a sort of fictitious podcast. So I want to make sure I'm selecting the part of the clip where she's putting her earbuds in. So it'll be these 3 seconds here. Yeah, that's good. And for this one, this is 35 seconds, but this is going to be my last slide. So this can be a little bit longer, let's say 5 seconds. And I only really want the very first 5 seconds. Okay, cool. That looks good. And I'm going to just go ahead and add some text to these. Now, whenever you're adding text to a video, you want to make sure you have enough white space around your subject so that the video is not overlapping with any kind of things that are happening inside of the video. So you can always double click on your video clip and then drag it to make sure that only the part of the video clip that you want to be showing is showing. And that creates a little bit more space for you to use. Now I'm going to be getting rid of all these palm leaves, because that's not quite right for the content. And I'm just going to go ahead and start adding in text. Keep in mind that just as you saw with promo and with ad zombies, you want to be using really simple fonts and putting them in caps whenever possible. So it's really, really easy for people to read quite quickly as it's coming through their feed. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and add in all my text. All right, so that's all my fonts. I would want to add in a few additional elements here. So I'm going to look for some podcast icons that I can maybe use. So I'm going to jump on over to graphics and select this little podcast microphone to use over here. And I'm also going to use maybe some headphones because I'm saying, hey, listen now. So that's when I could use a little headphones icon because I've already got the microphone in the actual video here and that's all lined up. Okay, so currently my video is only 17 seconds. That's pretty good. I could potentially cut that down a little bit more, but I don't really mind. Basically, all I'm trying to do at this stage is just hook them in with a couple of lines about this kind of fictitious podcast. So it would be a podcast that would share profitable marketing tips, successful growth strategies, and then it'd say all of this and more. And then it's sort of teasing the fact that it's a podcast. And then this is an actual call to action to say, click the link to listen now. So I'm pretty happy with how that's turning out. We've got a couple of things left to do. One would be to add in some music. And the second thing is to add in some logical transitions. So the problem with the Canva templates is that sometimes they will give you lots of transitions that don't necessarily make sense, especially because Canva currently at the time of recording don't offer an option for you to have transitions in but not out. So what that means is if you choose a transition, it's going to fade in and also fade out, and then the next one's going to fade in and fade out, and it's a little bit too much animation. So my best practices for you for animation purposes is to just choose one animated element on your video clip per page. So what that means is I would just say, I don't want any of the other elements to be animated. I'm just going to say none for the page itself, none for the video. Make sure that none of that is animated, but the actual text, I would maybe try to put it in as breathe because that's quite a nice transition. And then I would do the same for all of the other pages. Okay, so that's already looking pretty good. Now, what you might have noticed is that I actually removed the video that was in the background of this, and it's actually cut my ad down now to 14 seconds, which is perfect. Under 15 seconds is ideal. And my last little touch, and this is totally optional, is I actually like having a bit of a slightly transparent version of this middle video in the background for a little bit of that kind of attention-grabbing element when somebody comes across this video on their feed. So all I would do there is I'll just make sure to ungroup this so I'm only grabbing the actual video clip and then copy and paste that. So it's actually going to give me the exact timing that I've selected for this middle ad. And now I'm just going to place that all the way in the back and make that slightly transparent. So it's only kind of really, really slight. But when this plays, it's actually going to be playing both clips at the same time. So it looks quite cool. And I'll show you exactly what that looks like in just a sec. But I'm just going to do the exact same thing here. Now, obviously, this music makes no sense with this ad. So what I would want to do is go over to Elements. And actually, I would add in one additional element to this end just to break up the darkness of this to make it a little bit more on brand for me. And I would just add this into the corner. So if you're ever looking for kind of neutral elements, this one, in terms of search terms, I think it comes under blob, animated blobs, whatever. But I usually just search for the term white. And then I go over to this toggle and say animated, and that will pop up any sort of white animated elements that you can use in your designs if you go on over to graphics. So that's a really easy way. You can just bring in a couple of different highlight elements into your designs that make it a little bit more interesting for somebody to look at. But then you would want to go over to audio. So obviously this isn't going to make too much sense anymore. And I would say something like, I guess, happy or inspirational, and try and have a look at some audio options there. You know what? That's actually not too bad. I don't mind that. So I would replace that just by dragging it in. Same as with your video clips, you want to make sure you're trimming it to the sections that you want and you want to make sure that it's actually being applied to the whole clip as a whole, which it is, hopefully. So let's try and play that again. It's a little bit too slow to start. Yeah. So I would move it to where that beat drops so that it's really interesting for someone straight away. And that's pretty much it. So then all you would do is you would download that straight away. It's only 14 seconds and use that straight in your ads. And that's it, guys, for today's tutorial on how to make awesome video ads for Facebook and Instagram. I hope you found it helpful and learned something new. Let me know what you thought in the comments. And as always, I would really appreciate it if you found this video helpful, if you would subscribe to the channel and hit your notification bell so you don't miss out on any future content. Thank you so, so much for being here today. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you have an amazing rest of your day, and I'll see you in the next one.